check, yeah, fest, check, yeah. Now which one of y'all was talking shit about the set? I come through in the drop Porsche, two-tone colors. Uh-huh. You and your man, y'all could be Tombstone brothers. What's good, y'all? Still one and only Omar Fina, the most renowned voice in sports. Make sure you hit that like button if you're new. Go and subscribe to the Phenomenal Crew. Now, let's get to it. Listen. We here, baby. We fucking here. NFC Championship game. Brady versus Rodgers. It's what the NFL been wanting for the past decade. I can't name how many times the NFL has wanted Brady versus Aaron Rodgers in a win or go home situation. And that's what we get in this Sunday. Brady, the most accomplished quarterback, the greatest quarterback of all time, versus probably the greatest thrower of the football we ever seen. I mean, if we just being objective, we just keeping the buck, Aaron Rodgers probably throws the best football. This is coming from a Seahawks fan, Russell Wilson. I honestly think that, no, I'm not going to get into that Russell Wilson conversation. Just know we're talking about one of the most talented quarterbacks ever to walk this earth in Aaron Rodgers. Both squaring off in the NFC Championship game to see who's going to that Super Bowl. And hear me out. You know I'm rocking with Brady, man. There's no suspense to this. I'm rocking with Brady. Listen. I told y'all before, and I told y'all again, man. Brady is not looking to go home, man. Brady is all for it. He wants to rub it in Belichick's face. He wants to rub it in to all the haters that doubted that Brady played a big part in the Patriots. No. Brady has shown that the Patriots dynasty was him. And he's going to keep on going. And I don't see Aaron Rodgers beating him. I just don't see it, man. Hear me out. The Bucks and the Patriots played early in the season, of course, right? They played week 6, I believe. It was week 6 when they took on the Packers in Tampa. Brady and the Bucks, they laid the smackdown. Brady laid the smackdown on Rodgers. That Buccaneers D was stifling. Aaron Rodgers only had 10 points. He had 10 points in the first quarter. And then ever since he threw that pick to Jamal Dean, that pick 6 to Jamal Dean, everything went downhill. Two back-to-back picks. Brady just kept on putting points up. They ran the ball with Ronald Jones. Gronk had it himself. That was probably Gronk's best game. He had 2 tubs that game. So, you know, overall, listen, how I look at it is, do I expect it to be a repeat performance where the Buccaneers just beat the Packers by 28 points? No, because it's in Lambeau. It's in Lambeau. It's a playoff game. And, you know, overall, just because you blow a team in the regular season doesn't mean that that's going to happen. We just seen the Saints who blew out Brady and the Buccaneers. The same Brady and Buccaneers team that advanced the NFC Championship game. Breeze and the Saints blew them out in week 9, 38-3, lost in the divisional round. So, like, at the end of the day, I know shit can happen. Aaron Rodgers, he's the MVP, Mr. 48 touchdowns. But it's the Bucks time. It's Brady time, man. It's Brady time, y'all. It's Brady time, man. At the end of the day, Brady wants to make it to that Super Bowl. Brady wants that 7th ring, man. I don't think anything is stopping Brady getting that 7th ring, man. I don't care about the cold weather in Lambeau Field. Oh my goodness, the Buccaneers, they can't play in cold weather. They play in a warm city like Tampa. They play in Florida. They play in a warm climate. Well, I'm sorry, but the last time I checked, Brady is the greatest cold weather quarterback of all time. There's not a better football player to ever walk this earth that has played better, that's performed in the brightest lights in cold weather than Tom freaking Brady. So it's like at the end of the day, y'all, I'm not worried about the cold weather. Brady's playing in Foxborough for the past 20 years, y'all. You got Gronk played in Foxborough for pretty much all his career. Antonio Brown's played in Pittsburgh for most of his career. At the end, you got Jason Pierre-Paul on the defensive side. He played in MetLife. You had Sue, who played in Detroit. He had to play the Packers twice a year. So it's like, at the end of the day, y'all, I really think that cold weather narrative is just being overblown. It's being overblown. You got enough veteran players that have played in cold weather. So, you know, overall, you got some core players like Mike Evans and Chris Godwin and Leonard Fournette that haven't played in a cold weather climate. But at the end of the day, we've seen a lot of these top players on this Buccaneers team perform in cold weather. So it's like, at the end of the day, I'm not trying to hear this cold weather bullshit and how the Buccaneers can't perform in cold weather. They got Tom freaking Brady, who's played in Foxborough for the past 20 years and has performed at the highest level in cold weather. So whether it's snowing, whether it's cold rain and it's 20 degrees, what I'm hearing is it's supposed to be 31 degrees with some wind. So, you know, overall, I'm not worried about that. Brady, so you think Brady's sleepy, is nervous about cold weather? You think Brady is losing sleep due to having to play an NFC Championship game in cold weather? Come on now, you can't be serious. You can't be serious. If you really think that Brady can't perform in cold weather, you out your mind. So you know, overall, how I'm looking at this game is the Buccaneers just came off their best defensive performance of the year. The Devin White is an animal. Lavonte David is an animal. Sue, Shaq Barrett, JPP, Sean Murphy Bunting, the secondary locking up, Antoine Winfield, Carlton Davis. The defense is hot. Now, I'm recording this, of course, on Friday. So there hasn't been any reports of if Vita V is going to play or not. Bruce Arians said early in the week that Vita V is looking good. Now, I'm not sure if he's going to play or not, so I can't make any assumptions. But regardless of Vita V is out there or not, regardless if he's out there or not, that run defense is still going to be hell. The Buccaneers had the number one run defense in the league, regardless of Vita V or not. So it's like, at the end of the day, they're going to be able to get pressure. I expect Shaq Barrett and JPP to get there, especially with David Bakhtiari out. Don't forget, y'all. Don't forget that the best left tackle, one of the best left tackles in the league, the best tackle, the best offensive lineman on this team, David Bakhtiari, torn his ACL. So they missing their star left tackle, which means JPP, Shaq Barrett, the blitzes that Todd Bowles be sending, they're going to most likely get there again. That was the issue in the first game. Aaron Rodgers is under pressure, whether it was Sue, whether it was JPP, whether it was Shaq Barrett, whether it was Devin White or Lavonte David coming from the blitzes. At the end of the day, I expect them to get there. I want to see the Buccaneers play that same aggressive way that they play versus the Saints. Now, granted, you playing Aaron Rodgers, which is a big difference between Brees. 2020 Brees and 2020 Aaron Rodgers are total different players. Brees, he wasn't pushing that ball down the field. Old man Brees was not going to push the ball down the field. We all know Aaron Rodgers still throws one of the best deep balls in the league. He throws the second best deep ball. Nobody's fucking with Russ when it comes to that deep ball, but Aaron Rodgers throws the second best deep ball in the league. So, you know, I wouldn't just play conservative, because the issue is if you play conservative, then Davante Adams is going to eat you up underneath. So, you know, you still got to play aggressive. Let Carlton Davis and Murphy and Jamal Dean press a bit. But you just going to get a tad bit more creative on the back end. But I would still send Devin White. I would still send Lavonte David to get after Rodgers and make Aaron Rodgers make plays after plays after plays. This is what y'all don't get also. You look at the Packers dominating those sorry ass Lambs. Listen, y'all. You think the Jamal Williams and Aaron Jones is gonna be able to run all over the Buccaneers run D like they did the Rams? The Packers offensive line dominate the line of scrimmage. You think they finna dominate Sue and Golston and JPP and Shaq Barrett? I doubt it. This is the number one run D in the league. So you're not running up the middle. You got Devin White and Lavonte David running all over the sidelines. So you're not running, that pretty much takes the running game out the way. And listen, as great as a receiver Davante Adams is, there's no number two receiver. I know Lazar had a good game, but I'm sorry. At the end of the day, y'all, I'm rocking with the Bucks. Do I think it's going to be a competitive game? Do I think it's going to be a close game? Yeah, I do. It's Brady versus Rodgers in the NFC Championship game. The NFL is going to make sure this is a close game. All right, please don't get it twisted. The refs will not make this a blowout. The refs won't make this a blowout. But this is a game that the NFL have been wanting for years. They wanted it in 2014. Seahawks fans, my fellow Seahawks fans, don't forget that in 2014, we were not supposed to go to Super Bowl that year. There was a reason why we were down by 14 points with less than 5 minutes to go. It's because they wanted Aaron Rodgers versus Brady in 2014. So it's like at the end of the day, y'all, I'm rocking with Brady. Or listen, hear me out. Are you going to trust Brady in a win or go home game? Or are you going to trust Aaron Rodgers? Aaron Rodgers for the past decade has done nothing but choke in these type of games. Aaron Rodgers has done nothing but choke in these type of games. And I get it. All those NFC Championship games he played were on the road. Traveling to Seattle, that was on the road, of course. He traveled to San Fran. Twice, Colin Kaepernick, and then he just got his brains blown out last year to Jimmy G. He traveled down to the A. But I mean, at the end of the day, these are the type of games that Aaron Rodgers lose. These are the type of games that Aaron Rodgers just lose. So it's like at the end of the day, y'all, I'm rocking with the Bucks. I'm rocking with Brady, man. This is gonna be the perfect opportunity for y'all to watch Brady clutch out a game in a clutch situation and watch Aaron Rodgers choke a game in a tight situation. This has been the difference between Brady and Aaron Rodgers' career. Brady gets it done and Aaron Rodgers falls on his face. So, you know, at the end of the day, I expect sometime or Sunday around 4 to 5 o'clock for Rodgers to choke away a game. Whether it's JPP or Shaq Barrett stripping, making a strip sack, forcing the fumble on Aaron Rodgers. At the end of the day, I'm rocking with number 12 in Tampa. Real talk. Do y'all really think Brady and the Buccaneers are going to miss out an opportunity to be the first team to play in the Super Bowl that they're hosting? You out your mind. Brady's going to show out. That running game is there. Don't forget the Packers still can't stop the run. I'm not certain that the Packers can stop the run. Did they look good versus Derrick Henry a few weeks ago? Yeah, but Cam Akers had like damn near 100 yards on 18 carries. So I think the Packers can still get ran on. So I expect a playoff Lenny to do damage. Rojo do damage. I'm not sure if AB is playing or not. I think Bruce Arians said that's going to be a game time decision. But I'm going to keep it a buck, y'all. The Bucks got weapons for days, even if AB is not out there. Mike Evans, Chris Godwin, Gronk, Scott Miller. Hell, Tyler Johnson had the biggest catch of the game last week. So it's like at the end of the day, y'all, give me the Bucks. Give me Brady and the Bucks. And, you know, we're going to be smoking on that Aaron Rodgers pack Sunday night. All right, real talk. But that's all you got to say, y'all. That's all. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. I'm the Phenomenal One. And I'm out. Deuces. Shout out my Crips, they're still crippin', nigga. Shout out my Bloods, they're still bloodin', nigga. Straight from the dirt, shout out my muddy niggas. Came from the bottom, all my get money niggas. When I die, you ain't got to cry, you just got to pray. Put some weed where I lay, I'ma see you another day. Full of energy, you my enemy, you got to pay. Was on the east side, fucking with them Crips the other day. Was on the west side.